Few artists break through with a new musical genre as Pearl Jam did with grunge over a decade ago. Well, the Seattle Rockers are back with their first album in 4 years, and they have just kicked off a world tour in Europe. The group is proving its staying power with its latest effort, Binaural, which entered the Billboard album charts at number 2. Pearl Jam sat down with World Beat to give us the inside track on the album, the current state of rock and roll, and the legacy of grunge in this exclusive television interview.
Type of recording, it's called, you know, binaural recording, and there's certain ways to do it, whether it's like two microphones clipped here. Not just record the instruments, but record like the air around the instruments, and you can hear it. There's a song called Of the Girl, I think, and you know, you can hear Mike McCready's guitar, and you really feel the space of the room, and that's something that you kind of miss from modern recordings, you know, which may be done on Pro Tools or computer, or you know, it's just a miking technique, but I think we're successful in capturing some of the moods that happen in the room by adding some of that room sound.
It's very textural, and I think that really comes through in some of the stuff Off the Girl and Of the Girl and Sleight of Hand and just Nothing as It Seems. It's out of my hands, make it more hands me.
Trust me as I stumble and I breathe. I think communicating like between people is hard enough. I think everyone's got it's hard for people to just get to the core, whether it's not knowing how to say something or the situation in order to say it or the timing of something you want to say. And I think music has been a vehicle, I've seen it, as being able to communicate or use it as a vehicle to communicate using, you know, the rhythms and volume and the melody. I think, you know, it's something I wanted to take advantage of, you know, have a chance to communicate. And I think that's another reason why, you know, you don't want to put your face everywhere, because I think even the face gets in the way. So, you know, just having it be kind of that voice in the dark, and then, you know, maybe it can, you know, hit home every once in a while.
How important is commercial success to you?
Well, we got it so quickly.
Right.
So then it was really, we were very fortunate where we didn't have to care. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, we can have our blasé attitude about it and do strictly what we want to do because we were afforded that. And I think it's a great opportunity to have. And I'm glad we, you know, take advantage of it. So we don't actually base our decisions on that process at all.
During that whole, through the second and third record even, I think I felt like we kind of got ripped off of that slow rise that REM got, or, you know, but then there's a part of me that feels like it was good to kind of get that over and done with, and then, you know, it took a little while to kind of come out of that and just be at a point to where we can make records and tour when we want to.
Does grunge still exist today?
You know, is it significant? Does it exist anymore? Are there people still?
I think Bruce Pavitt's still making a little bit of residuals from it.
Well, I think that something very important happened last week, and the Melvins played in Seattle. The Melvins, who came from Aberdeen and Cobain's hometown, They played Seattle, they played Teen Spirit, and Leif Garrett was singing. And Chris Novoselic came out and ran on stage and took a couple photos, and I think that's it. I think that capped the end. It is official. It's over. Put a stick in it, gravestone. Don't try. It's over.
That's it for this week's edition of World Beat.